My name is Justin Strand, and this is Jesse Strand with me. You behave, okay? Happy third week of Advent. During the Advent season, our Wednesday midweek devotions each focus on a different Christmas carol and the story behind each of them. Today, we focus on the story of Silent Night. Isaiah 7:14 says, "Therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel." You may have noticed that the reading we just heard was from the Old Testament, not the Gospel of Luke or any other accounts of Jesus' birth. This miracle of our Savior coming to earth as a baby was planned by God many years before. The story of Silent Night comes from a small town named Oberndorf, a Tyrol village in Austria near Salzburg. On December 23, 1818, a roving band of actors was performing in towns throughout the Austrian Alps. They arrived in Oberndorf, where they were going to reenact the story of Christ's birth in the small church of St. Nicholas. But unfortunately, the organ at the church was not working. Because of this, the performers presented their drama in a private home. The priest of St. Nicholas Church, Father Joseph Moore, attended the presentation of the Christmas story, and it left him in a meditative mood. He decided to take a longer way home. This path took him to a hilltop which overlooked the village. As he looked at the peaceful snow-covered village and mused on the thoughts of the Christmas play from the first chapters of Matthew and Luke, Father Moore remembered a poem he had written years before about the angels announcing the birth of the long-awaited Messiah to the shepherds on a hillside. He decided that those words would make a good carol for his congregation to sing at the Christmas Eve service. There were two problems. He didn't have music for the poem yet, and the organ still wasn't working. The next day, he took the text to the organist, Franz Xaver Gruber. He had a few hours to compose a melody, which he accomplished. So on December 24th, 1818, Silent Night was sung for the first time by Franz Gruber and Joseph Moore, as Franz accompanied on his guitar. Later, when Karl Marascher came to repair the church organ, Gruber tested his work by playing the melody of Silent Night. Marascher was deeply impressed and took copies of the music and words back to his own Alpine village of Kapfing. The music reached the Strasser family, who were makers of chamois skin gloves. To help drum up business at festivals and fairs, the four Strasser children would sing the carol in front of their parents' booth. Silent Night became known as a Tiroler Volkslied, or folk song of the Tyrol. As the children sang, people felt it was a perfect song for the snow-clad region and the Christian heart. In 1834, Silent Night was even sung by the Strasser sisters for King Frederick William IV of Prussia. He liked it so much that he ordered it to be sung by his cathedral choir every Christmas Eve. In 1838, the carol was published in a German hymn book, Katholisches Gesang und Gebet für den öffentlichen und hauslichen Gottesdienst zunächst zum Gebrauch der katholischen Gereinden Königreiche Sachsen. Freely translated, this means Catholic songs and prayers for public and domestic worship, in addition to the use of carols for the Catholic region of Saxony. I apologize to all the German speakers out there if that was not quite right. Silent Night was brought to the United States by the Rainer sisters in 1844, where they sang the carol in German at New York City's Trinity Church. Nearly 50 years later, it was translated to English. In 1863, the words of Silent Night were printed in Charles Hutchins' Sunday School hymnal. Today's Silent Night is sung around the world in over 300 languages. Each year, on December 24th at 5 p.m. Central Europe time, the city of Oberndorf, Austria, honors the two creators of Silent Night, Franz Gruber and Joseph Moore. It is broadcast live by webcam. One of my favorite lyrics from this carol is the phrase, "Glory stream from heaven afar, heavenly hosts sing Alleluia." For me, it evokes a vivid image of this huge host of angels suddenly appearing in the sky, brilliantly shining and singing praises to God, while the shepherds watch in silent awe. This image fills me with awe and wonder too at the beauty and majesty of the Lord revealed in this angelic display. So to conclude, I would like to sing the second verse of Silent Night. You can join in at home too. Silent night, holy night, shepherds quake at the sight, glory stream from heaven afar, heavenly hosts sing Alleluia, Christ the Savior is born, Christ the Savior is born.